Israel is now being urged against obliterating Gaza altogether, with fears that would result in untold civilian casualties, more women, children and the elderly. America's tone is now more cautious, while still ramping up its own military presence in the region to help keep Israel's other enemies out of the fight. Our European correspondent Ashley Mullaney and chief reporter Chris Reason have the very latest from the Gaza border.
This is Israel's other war. Lebanon, to the north, home to Hezbollah. On the tiny border, they exchange rockets, missiles, gunfire and anger. The sirens are sounding, not just for locals, but around the world, with fears of this conflict spilling over the borders, igniting a Middle East war. Enter the Americans. Today, a second aircraft carrier on its way to sit off Israel, the USS Dwight D. Eisenhower, dragging with it a battle group of destroyers, frigates, subs, and over 90 aircraft. Warship diplomacy.
No one should do anything that widens this conflict in any way or that furthers aggression against Israel from any other direction.
The Eisenhower joins another carrier group already there, the USS Gerald R. Ford, parked in the eastern Mediterranean. A power move to intimidate Hezbollah in Lebanon and any surrounding nation nearby, especially Iran. The Israelis continue to pour their forces into the area around Gaza. Tens of thousands of troops and reservists ordered to the front lines, while the air and artillery campaign, which began a week ago, continues to grind on. And the misery inside the tiny territory gets worse. At this hospital, daily mayhem. Doctors running out of medicine, food and time to save lives.
Another war crime, another, like, tragedy which will be historical.
As more families bury their dead, we're told these bodies are stored in ice cream trucks, because the morgues are full. This is Rafah, the gate to Egypt and freedom, but it's shut. Pressure growing on Egypt to open up, relieve the pressure and misery. Today, a sense of what the Israeli ground force will come up against. Just some of the Hamas weapons seized after the October 7 terror attacks. Israel's soldiers know that every day of delay gives Hamas more time to prepare, reinforcing their kilometres-long network of tunnels deep beneath Gaza.
Chief reporter Chris Reason is near the Gaza border.
7 News was live on air as the alarm gave us 15 seconds to run for our lives.
PM today. Let's go. We're actually, let that camera roll. Come, someone, go.
Our chief reporter there, Chris Reason.
And I don't know if you can still hear us, but
Chris,
we're obviously inside the shelter across the road.
The kind of reality that Israel's population grapples with daily, the kind of reality many Australians here want to escape. Today, the first Australian military presence in the region, the RAAF's giant C-17 transport plane, normally carries bushmasters and tanks. Today, a more precious cargo, airlifting thankful Australians. Three flights in total today, 2 military, 1 a commercial charter.
I'm sad to be leaving Israel, but I'm also grateful to Australia.
She's been living in Israel the last 2 years.
I'll be back here as soon as I can be.
Yet despite over 1,200 Australians registered as wanting to leave, only 255 turned up at Ben Gurion Airport.
For Australians who want to leave, I can't emphasise this enough. I strongly encourage you to take the first option you can. Please do not wait for another option.
Even Israelis are evacuating some parts of their country. Towns near Gaza emptying before the assault begins.
This is Sderot, the closest Israeli town to Gaza, 2.5 kilometres over there. Its population is normally 30,000, but right now it feels like a ghost town. More than half its residents have already been evacuated in the anticipation that this will be Israel's latest front line.
A town now devoid of women and children.
They were afraid and they left.
Their military, though, not afraid or running. Israel's Air Force tonight releasing these pictures. This and much more await in the days ahead. In Sderot, Israel.
And Ashley Mullaney joins me now from the Gaza border. Ash, Israeli troops are now in final training for this attack.
And Mark, they will be moving into an extremely complex battlefield. Hence, Israel has been dropping bombs to clear the way for tanks and infantry. We are just over a kilometre from the border. You can see the fence that separates Gaza from Israel over there. But what you can't see are the troops and the tanks, thousands of them that are lined up over that ridgeline, ready to move in. This will be a multi-pronged assault from Israel, from the land, the air and the sea. But make no mistake, Hamas is preparing for battle too. They've had control of Gaza for the past 17 years, and in that time they've built a complex network of tunnels, like a honeycomb network of tunnels underground, and Israel can't know where all of them are. It is hard to imagine a scenario more horrific than what we saw last weekend, but it seems war is certain and there will be more suffering. Mark.
Ashley Mullaney live from the front line. Thank you. Outspoken Senator Lydia Thorpe has compared the Australian government to Israel in a speech supporting Palestinians. Ms Thorpe wore a traditional Palestinian scarf in the Senate as she likened their struggle to that of Indigenous Australians.
I'm not surprised that the Australian government, which is itself a legal occupier of these very lands, condones illegal occupation of other lands and sides with an oppressive regime.
Senator Thorpe says she condemns the Hamas attack on Israel. Closer to home, the federal government has pledged a further $10 million to help protect religious communities from racially motivated crime and violence. Let's go live to Chris Maher in Neutral Bay. Chris, key community centres here in Australia are getting money for security upgrades.
Mark, it's federal government funding in response to rising fears that religious-based sites here could be targeted. Now, it comes in the wake of the widely condemned pro-Palestinian protest at the Opera House. The now $50 million grants program will boost safety and security around faith-based installations. They include places of worship, religious schools and also community groups. The Prime Minister says there are hundreds of applications for assistance. Their processing will be fast-tracked this week.
We have no room for anti-Semitism in this nation. Just as we have no room for Islamophobia, we have no room for hatred.
Jewish parents are concerned about their children wearing their Jewish school uniform in public.
The Prime Minister expects announcements on the funding in coming days. Mark.
Chris Maher, Neutral Bay, thank you.